All right, shop timers, this could be it. Our very last pass on the last rod for this Cletrac motor. Wish me some luck. Hey, there it is, shop timers. We got four pistons in this block. We're ready to move on to the next step. It only took 6 years to get this far. Wow. All right. We'll bring it back when some more progress is made. Look at this, shop timers. Brand new shiny head gasket ready to go on. Let's get that head ready. Get it on there. All right, shop timers, make this a quick one. We're about to run out of battery power. Look at that. The head's on. Torqued it down to about 45 pounds in a circular pattern. I think we'll wait a while and come back and torque it down again after it settles a little bit. Just for looks, we set the timing cover on there. It's not bolted down yet. And if anybody knows what this tube is right here, let me know, because I haven't seen that in the other pictures I've found. Hey, we'll bring it back when we're ready for more. All right, shop timers, we're back again. We got this bushing that is cut off of this clutch pedal here. We're going to make a new one. As you can see, it's pretty well wore out. So the first thing we're going to do is line it up on the mill. And I think we're going to drill this out to a bigger size, because this just ain't enough meat for my tastes. Alright guys, I'll bring it back. Alright, I just used a 3/4 inch drill to line that up roughly. It's not super precision. If you look at this old bushing, it wasn't precision before. So let's get started with this. We're going to take it out to 13/16. Let's put a little oil on here. First time I ever used this drill. I guess it's doing all right. Just take her nice and slow. There we go. Bob's your uncle, as they say. All right, we're back with the boring head. Let's try giving that a try and enlarge this hole some. I think we'll take her out to 875. I don't want to go too far and lose all of our meat. There she is. Now, I started making this bushing some point in time in the past, but we're going to finish it now. This will fit into that hole we just bored on the mill. There's the first pass. I'll bring it back when we're closer to being done. All right, that didn't take long. Let's do a little cleanup spring pass here. That'll do it. All right, we're back again. Let's put a nice chamfer on there to help that weld really sink in. That'll do it. Alright guys, got her done, pressed into that there clutch pedal, ready for some weld. Let's see how she looks. Look at that. Like a glove. Thank you.
27,000 vehicles have replaced the 40,000 steam locomotives operating on mainline rail at the end of World War II. Before steam power was harnessed by the railroads for commerce, traffic, and romanticized by tourists, it was simply energy being transferred as heated water molecules expanded. The concept of steam built a piston-driven steam engine to pump water out of coal mines. In 1769, Scottish engineer James Watt perfected Newcomen's idea and patented the first. And bearings lubricated. Only then can the engine begin to move. Spent coals are dumped from the ash pan. Fresh coal and water are added to the tender. When the engine's up to speed and the crew has its operating orders, the locomotive.
Thank you.